It is foolish to ask, will I be able to get into the kingdom of heaven? There is no other place you can stay, for that is your real home. You don't have to earn it. You are already God's child, made in His image. You have only to tear away the mask of the human being and realize your divine birthright. But if our Creator is impersonal, how is it that He has created human beings? We are personal. We think, feel, will, and God has given us not only the power to appreciate the thoughts and feelings of others, but to respond to them. The Lord is surely not devoid of the spirit of reciprocity that animates His own creatures. When we permit it, our Heavenly Father can and will establish a personal relationship with each one of us. Him intimately. He is the nearest of the near, the dearest of the dear. Love Him as a miser loves money, as an ardent man loves his sweetheart, as a drowning person loves breath. It is His love that I speak of, thrill after thrill, like gentle zephyrs, His love comes over the soul. Day and night, week after week, year after year, it goes on increasing. You don't know where the end is. You are all gods. Close your eyes and you see the vast omnipresence before you. Wherever you look, you are in the center of that sphere, and you will find that sphere filled with the great joy and bliss. Awake. Whenever your mind wanders in the maze of worldly thoughts, patiently lead it back to remembrance of the indwelling Lord. In time you will find Him ever with you, a God who talks with you in your own language, a God whose face peeps at you from every flower and shrub and blade of grass. Then you shall say, I am free. I fly from earth to heaven on wings of light, and what joy will consume your being.